Well, today I would like to talk about a GUI package called PySimple GUI. Let me just show my interest, why I'm interested in PySimple GUI. I had some experience with animation, quite technical in Tika Inter, because I have a kind of simulation package. But then I also had some project that could use an attractive GUI. And my first idea was then Tika Inter, but it's kind of tricky. And then I had practically no experience with those GUIs. And then I got into contact with the sole developer and maintainer of this PySimple GUI package through a forum I join regularly. And I thought, well, this is a good start. And but you have to remember, I'm not really a GUI expert. I just wanted to show you what I found, and I would do some live coding, just building one or two small projects. So the what's on the menu for today? Just some short introduction to GUIs. What is PySimple GUI? I want to do, if possible, two sample applications. Show you a little bit of what PySimple can do with the work from others. Some pros and cons, and then a conclusion. So why GUIs? Well, they're important because, well, if you just have a text interface, it doesn't really work. It's complicated, and even for simple tasks can be already very interesting to have the a pretty interface. But GUIs are usually quite complicated. They take time to set up, and so you have to know a lot of things. And that's why it's sometimes not very attractive to start with that. So for instance, a very small GUI, more or less a trivial thing, we have the input function. So we just ask for a number and another number, and they just add it up, and then we have a certain time. Well, this is not very attractive, of course. There's absolutely nothing there. Another example of a non-GUI application is a command line interface. For instance, Black, the formatter. If you want to run that one from the command line, you have a number of options, and you have to remember all the formats and all that. So it's also not very attractive. It would be nice to have a kind of interface for that, and we're going to work on that soon. What's there in the Python world? Well, one of the most obvious is Tika Inter, which comes standard with all or most Python installation. Has a lot of features, maybe a bit old-fashioned, but it's very flexible, but has a high learning curve and a not very intuitive API. Just to show you that here's just a very small example of an application and asking for two numbers to add them up. But there you have already quite a lot of code, and not that obvious. You have to do something here to define a route, but you have to start a main loop, something with grids, and there's callback options. So this is not that easy actually to do. I'll show you the same applications in a couple of minutes in Tika Inter. Then there are other GUI frameworks. The most well known are WXPython, PyQt, Skivy, which is interesting because that's also cross platform. But all of them has actually this quite long learning curve. They are powerful, and some of them even incur license costs. For instance, PyQt. Then there are some GUI builders for interactive systems. They're not very popular in the Python world, maybe because the interfacing is rather complex. And you have to maintain both the GUI part, which is usually then a kind of graphical interface, and the application. Some of the examples are Page and PyGubu. I'm not even sure whether they're well maintained or not. So then there's an alternative called PySimple GUI. which is a relatively new project, started 2 years ago. It's extremely actively maintained, which means that there are new versions very, very frequently released. It's open source. And what's the interesting thing is that it runs actually under or on four different platforms. It's available on TK Inter, which is actually the main branch. There's PyQt, there's WX Python, and this is also interesting. You can also make a web interface, and in principle, they have all the same API. I want to do something with the TK Inter version of PySimple GUI, and therefore I'm going to switch to Python now. So what I want to do is build this simple adder application, which has two numbers and the results, calculate button here, and we're going to build it. So start really from scratch. So the first thing you have to do is import PySimple GUI as G, that's a quite good convention. Then we say, see, that's also the Qt version. Then we go and define those rows. And those rows are actually are just defined as a list of all the elements that are in there. So what's there? We start with a text field. And the text field is of course the title, the name, number one. Then we have an input field. And the input field needs to be identified later. So I just have to give a key. And so that's the that second field. And the third field is a button with the name, with the title calculate. Okay, that's row one. Now row two is more or less the same, of course. So I just say here row two, just change the ones and twos. Remove the button, we don't have a button on this line. Just calculate. And then we have row three. Well, row three is actually just a text. Text result. And then followed by another field, another text field. And that text field has to have a size, because we're going to fill that later. Wait a minute, I can also do this easier. And then it has already a size, and then this one needs a key. I have to reference to that, and the reference is then result. And that's actually it. Then I just say, okay, I want to formulate all those things, which we'll call a layout. A layout is, and that's a row, that's a list of row one, row two, and row three. And then I just make a window, and the window is actually making this whole thing. I just add a title, header, and a layout to indicate what it looks like. And then we can already test it, and I'm sure there will be some mistakes in the window dot read. This is just a dummy. Just go and test it. What's happening? Oh, it's very slow for some reason. So we made a mistake. Needed a comma. Real life conference, you always people shout, made a mistake, but that's not possible now, I'm afraid. Windows not defined. Maybe there. Okay, well, it doesn't do anything. Here you can see actually already the whole layout and all that, but it doesn't do anything yet because I haven't defined anything. But what I'm now going to replace this with a small event loop while two, you will always. Then I just read this window, returns an event and some values. And then I could say if event is st.window closed, in that case we are done. We're done, so we break. And otherwise, we just go and say if event is, and then you just get the name of the button, calculate. In this case, this is the only action that can cause an event. Calculate. Then we can just get the number. So we say number one is the integer of, and then we read the this field here, which is then thank you. Then we just, this is the we just say values of number one, because those are all strings. We just do the next line, same story. So now we have the two numbers, then let's just adding them up. Two. And then we just want to display them. Then you do that by window, and then I look up this value result. This is this key, this field. So I just say result dot update result. And then that should work. A little bit of luck. Yeah, so now I can just show you that it works. 10 plus 33 is not correct. No, it doesn't say that correctly. I'm sorry, it's so slow. It must have to do with the Zoom connection at the same time. Okay, then you can just calculate. It's 45. And now it's a problem here, and I want to show you something. If I just say an invalid value, then you get the value error. And then I can just show you some of the other features. Then I just say, okay, I want to check this one. And then if I get a value error, because that's so easy. Then I just can do a pop up saying wrong. And I do something extra in this round as well. I just say, okay, I want to have some nice color scheme. That you can just do that with theme. And I know there's a nice one called Dark Amber. And let's also just add a tooltip, just to show you how simple that can be. I just add tooltip is enter an int. Yep. There we go. Okay, let me just, just do a, you see here the pop-up, and I can still run it, of course. It's not very spectacular. And if I go here over this one, you can see the tooltip. This is just in 10 minutes, an application I built. Now I want to do something else, but, this is a project. Well, this is actually much more useful. This is a kind of front end for Black, in which you ask actually for a folder, the line lengths, the targets, which is a kind of one of the input fields of for Black, and an output field. Well, I'm not going to do this live because that will take too much time, I think. But I could just go and open the already, this is the application, but this is not important. It's all about this part. So what you can see here actually is more or less still the same. This is that folder thing, and here at the end, I just make this big. The zoom button, the zoom system is in the way. Wait a minute. Yeah, he's done. Okay. So here we have the widget folder browse. Well, then that's some commands that you can search through the folders. Here's the line length, and now here I do a slider. So that's this one here. This is a slider. Then I do just give some parameters. I do a combo box for the target version, also with a key and all that, and then I do a text, a multi-line is this thing here, in which you can put whatever text you want, and there are two buttons here, so that are these two. And all these ones are actually just this one. Here I didn't use this layout thing because I did it all in once. Then there's the main loop, and the main loop is nothing more than what you just saw. If the event is Black, and then we do something which is a bit complicated, but the interfacing with the Black system, which is a process. And then, let me just run this. And you can see that's already quite an interesting and attractive GUI to a complicated command line. And this is, well, just a minute, matter of a couple of minutes, of course. And here you see, I've got a Black theme, of course, and I can just say, okay, I want to browse. And then you get a browse folder automatically. You don't have to do anything about that. I just say, okay, I want to have a folder. And let me just do this one. And then I just select that folder. You can see that here I can just play with the line lengths. I can play here with the target version, and then I just say, okay, do it. Now in the background, it's running this sub-process to blacken, to run Black, which takes time, apparently. The output should appear here in this window. But the whole system is rather slow. Well, in this case, there's nothing. It just says all done. This is output from black. All done, two files left unchanged. And I get a pop-up here, which is just given here, and then we're done. So this is also a very simple, quickly built interface, but you can go much further than that, and that's what I want to show you now. For instance, well, this is actually quite easy. This is actually an example of an application I built to run on an Android phone, just also with the same PyCBook GUI interface. This is something to create a lockdown document here in France. We needed that. And now I just want to show you some of the application from the site, some interesting things, the interfacing with Matplotlib, and then you can just, this is all done in PyCBook GUI. You can just select all kinds of things. This is an example of a crossword puzzle. I think this is done with buttons. I'm not actually sure how this is done, but that's also one of the users who made this one. This is an interesting one. This is an application that's actually an OpenCV connection in which is actually this kind of traffic camera, apparently something with stolen cars. I don't know what it is exactly, but this is a real application that that someone made. Here you see all the different widgets that are available. Of course, there's much more available. There's also menus and everything, spin boxes, and really a lot of things. So, to conclude, well, first of all, I am by far not the PyCBook GUI expert. I just know a fraction of the functionality, but I can already do quite a lot of things with it. It has really a lot of widgets and features, interfaces with all kinds of packages. Of course, there's more or less something that's given by Python, of course. It supports threading, which is not obvious. That's quite often very complicated. It is cross-platform, which means that the different versions are more or less the same, not 100% the same. And one of the interesting ports is definitely the WebRemi interface. The documentation is really super. It's a whole set of documentation with reference guides and a good cookbook and all that, better than a lot of the GUIs themselves. So it's great for beginners, that's for sure, but also experts who don't want to spend that much time, for instance, to when you have a command line interface, and then it's a very nice thing to do, a nice thing to have. Well, of course, there are prepackaged solutions, many, but customization, you can customize nearly all the calls, but still there are limitations. So you can't control everything. And something also to consider is that this package is developed by just one man. And continuity, I don't know. So to conclude, actually, I want to say PyCBook GUI is a very attractive package. Worth to give it a try. And I would say go to his website, pycbgui.com, and then you will find out yourself, and then you won't be disappointed, I think. And then I would like to thank you for your attention. And if there are any questions, I'm here to answer them.
Thanks, Ruth.
Thank you.
There is one question here from Matthew. Really nice demonstration. Do you have any recommendations on when PyCBook GUI might be insufficient and you need to go with one of the more powerful libraries like Tkinter?
Yeah, I think particularly if you have, if there's really high end and you want really full control over all the placement of widgets and you want to do more things with callbacks in which you have to react on all kinds of actions at the same time. This package is particularly good in the things that they defined, but I can imagine that you can't really do everything in it. But well, as I said before, I'm not really a very GUI expert, but I understand that certain things can't be done with packages like that. But I also understand that at least you can escape to the ordinary version. So if you run PySimple GUI under GKinter, for instance, you can still break in into the main loop. I don't know how, but that seems to be possible.
Great, thanks. Metatux is asking, does Remy serve a web server, or is the output an HTML file with JavaScript?
As far as I know, it goes to Remy, and then you can see immediately the output. It's really a GUI in the web. I'm not sure how you have to have a look at Remy, and I don't know anything about Remy. I just know that there's an interface for that, and I've seen some very nice demonstrations of it.
All right, and we have another one, which is very new to Python programming in Linux. Applying this in a Linux environment, is it as simple as Windows? I guess, is this cross-platform?
Absolutely. And actually, I think most of it is actually developed in the Linux. I'm a Windows user, but I've used it also on Raspberry Pis under Linux, no problem at all. Mac OS is okay, and so the only thing which doesn't support, I'm a Pythonista. This is the iPad application running Python on an iPad, and there you can't use it because there's no GKinter available. So that's, for me, is still a problem.
All right, thanks, Ruud. I'm representing everyone watching.
Okay. Pleasure.